Houdini 19 has all sorts of new features. Let's dive in and check out one of the new nodes.
Attribute adjust color. This node is awesome. While it may not be bringing something entirely new to the table, it is a very neatly packaged shop with a lot of awesome possibilities. So let's dive into Houdini and take a look at the super fun node. The first thing you'll note is just how many parameters there are. It's a little bit overwhelming at first, as you can mix and match so many different options to get an infinite amount of possibilities. Let's start from the top. Firstly, you can stipulate the name of the attribute. By default, it'll work on CD, which we'll stick to for most of this video as it's a really nice visualization. It also has a blend mode. This is like an opacity slider. What's really cool is using a mask attribute to blend in your color layer. Of course, this was possible before, but this just makes it so much easier to use. We can also change the attribute class. If we set it to primitive, we can use a noise and set it to my favorite ramp, Inferno. Now, if we use an attribute adjust vector, we can change the attribute name to CD, make it a primitive, then we can output the length as Z scale and feed this into a poly extrude. In the poly extrude, let's be sure to check on the Z scale. Now we get some really cool extrusions. We can obviously change the noise or even adjust the settings in the attribute adjust vector or even the poly extrude. We can add some further things and get some really fun results. Pre-process lets you bring in attributes and make adjustments before color processing takes place. This is a great way to bring in an already existing attribute that you want to use as the base of your attribute adjust color. Now we get to the insane part. This is where you have so many options. Just like the normal color node, you can use a solid color if you want, but you also have a list of other options. Random will give you a random value for each point or primitive, depending on what you specify. You can use a color ramp to choose your colors. In Houdini 19, we got some really nice ramp presets. You can also choose a min and a max, and you can choose specific values. This is obviously awesome if you have specific colors that you want to map to your objects. There are also some really cool color palettes built into this section. In the color itself, there are even further options where you can use a list of cool presets. There's a randomization by element number, but it's also possible to specify an attribute for each object and use that to get unique colors for those groupings, such as the variant attribute when you're using a copy to point variant workflow. Noise creates a noise field that you can adjust with the usual noise settings. What's great is you can animate a noise as per usual, but you can also stack multiple attribute adjust colors and use the operation mode to stack noises. This opens up a world of possibilities to create some really nice procedural shaders and softs which can be transferred between geometries. The remap attribute mode will let you specify an incoming attribute and remap it to the values that you give it. This node has a compute range button which is really useful when you're unsure of your ranges. You can click it and it'll auto detect them for you. So you can feed it the velocity attribute from a particle simulation and you get some really cool results. Color map is very similar to the attribute from map, where you can bring in an image and map it to your UVs. This is point-based mapping, which is really useful when doing point-based simulations. You can also use the color to affect where cuts will happen by using a poly cut. Using the attribute adjust color, you can adjust some of the color settings to get some very different results. Remember, you can also stack color values to get cool effects. The line mode got me really excited. You can now drag and draw lines in your viewport, mapping colors to your points. This obviously has a huge range of possibilities. You can get some really nice gradients traveling across your individual objects. And just as before, you can choose specific colors and it'll split them across your drawn line path. Don't forget to try out some of the presets as they look really good. The radial mode is just like the line mode. You can now drag radial projections in your viewport. Something I find really useful is using a rest node to store a rest state, then distorting my shape with the mountain sop, then using an attribute adjust color set to radial mode. Finally, I'll use an attribute swap set to rest and P to restore my original shape's position. If you use animation on this, it looks really cool. Just like we've had to wrangle rel B box a million times, we can now use the bounding box dropdown to make it really fast to use the bounding box of our objects. There are also some neat adjustment settings, letting us dial in what we need really quickly. There are also different operation types, much like in Photoshop and other photo editing software, you can now stack colors and mix them based on different functions. I won't go over all of these as there are much better descriptions out there of how these all work, but it's worth mentioning that these give some amazing options. The other amazing feature is the color correction tab. We can now super easily adjust the colors. This is awesome for when you want to clamp or push values or achieve different effects. These values can all be adjusted by attributes too. So you can mask off areas that you want to be affected and those that shouldn't. You can also animate these values to get some really fun color effects. Getting to the end of this node, we can enable post-process and we can clamp the tops and the bottoms of our attributes. We can now remap them to the specified colors. We can also quickly change it to a complement color. So let's take a closer look at how we can set up some cool cutting based on the attribute adjust color. In this scene, I just have a grid. I'm then giving it some UVs with a UV project. I'm then using an attribute adjust color with the default picture set to color map. So I've got this picture here on my grid. I'm going to use the color values of this to drive a poly cut. We'll get to that in a second. I'm then using an attribute blur to just blur my colors slightly. I'm then setting an edge group, and this edge group is just so that I can pin the edges when I run the vellum solve. I'm then using a polycut and I'm setting it to the cd.g. This cut value is how much of the value it needs to look at before it starts cutting. So you'll see this cut value makes quite a big difference. The other thing we can now look at is this attribute blur. This also plays quite a big role in this. As you can see, without it, it has quite a lot of jagged edges. And if we just blur slightly, we get a lot more nice rounding cuts. Now, if we look at our attribute adjust color, we have some settings here that we can play with. If we play with the value, you'll see that as the values change, so do our cuts. And that is the same with the hue shift. As we change the hue, we get different cuts. And this is always great to play with to see what results we can get. The next thing we can do is we can add an additional attribute adjust color. So we're going to take this noise and we're going to multiply it on top of our original color image. Let's have a look at what that noise looks like on its own. You can see I just have a very small, very faint noise. But when we multiply it over it, you can see how it takes these edges and it just gives it some nice jaggedness. If we turn it off, you'll see the difference that it makes. And obviously we can now play with these settings and change the values to get something else. So let's say I'm happy with these cuts. I can now use another attribute adjust color to put in the same picture again, but without all the distortion that we were seeing over here. I'm then using an attribute noise set to break threshold scale, just to break up some of the noise of where it's going to tear and break. I'm then using a vellum cloth with a vellum weld with this break threshold scale set. I can now hit play and we'll see this cool breaking effect. All in all, this node holds a ton of possibilities and makes it really easy to play with colors in the viewport. I'm sure there are so many uses that I haven't even thought of yet, so I'm excited to see what you use it for. It's time to dive in and check it out. Let's make something awesome.